Today, we're gonna look at some important features for making Google Slides accessible. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. The first thing you wanna do is open up a brand new presentation, and let's go ahead and give it a name. I'm going to name mine Accessible Google Slides. Now from here, we could add in a title, a subtitle, but what's more important is that we are using a slide that has a layout. So I can use title and body. There are lots of other ones like a title in two columns. And it's very important that you leave the content from within these placeholders. Anytime you add content from outside these placeholders, it can get a little challenging to maintain the accessibility. Now, one thing that is specific to things like Google Slides is ensuring that your slide titles are unique. So if we were to give this a slide title of, let's say, accessibility best practices, and then we had the exact same slide again, what we would want to do is throw in a little label that says one of two, and then on the other slide that has the same name, we would put two of two. What about things like hyperlink text? Well, this is the same across all platforms. You want to have a very clear and descriptive hyperlink text for any links that you will be using. I'm going to say, check out the Accessibility Guy's guide on making documents accessible. And what I'm going to do is select the words making documents accessible, right click, let's add in a hyperlink, and we will link to our correct website. This also will change the color of the hyperlink, and we have clear and concise alt text. What about if we wanted to add an image to this Google slide? Well, we can do that by selecting the insert button and then selecting image, and I'm going to search the web. And let's find an image that we can throw in here. And let's insert this image. I'm selecting one from the web, and it's an image of Stone Cold Steve Austin. Now the problem is it just slaps it on top of all of our other content. And so we need to be wary of a couple of things. But first, let's add in some alternate text. I'm going to right click the image and select alt text. And let's give this a description, Stone Cold Steve Austin. And we can also put in a title, greatest wrestler of all time. And now when I come onto the page and I select the tab key, it's going to walk me through all of the objects on the page in their order. So right now it's going to the title, it's going to my first text box, it's going to the next text box, and then to my image. So if I want to get this reading order correct, I want to actually delete those blank text boxes so that I just simply have my image. Now when I tab onto the page, we have the title followed by the image. If we wanted to change the reading order, we would have to right click the object, select order, and you would mess with the settings. If I select send to back, it's actually going to be the first thing that is read aloud. What about when you're using list items? Item one, item two, item three. It's important that you use the built-in formatting for things like this. Let's select those three items. And on the format tab, I'm going to select bullets and numbering. And let's select a bulleted list. And that will insert these objects as accessible list items for a screen reader. Let's take a look at how to insert a table into Google Slides. The most accessible way that you can add a table is by selecting the insert button and then select insert table. And we're gonna choose the number of rows and columns. And it's very important that your tables are very simple. Google Slides has difficulty in making tables accessible. So make sure that you make this content very simple and easy to understand. I'm putting in some dummy data. I actually don't even think there's a way to apply a table header to this content. So this is one of the downsides to using Google Slides. The screen reader is simply going to read from left to right, top to bottom. So that's how you would put in a table, but because Google Slides does not really make this accessible, I would try to avoid using tables wherever necessary. Additionally, if you wanted to insert a chart or graph, this is highly inaccessible inside of Google Slides. So what it does, I just did it by selecting insert a chart bar, and it just randomly put in this bar chart that is seen as an image. I have no ability to change I have no ability to apply patterns, change the labels, or really do anything with this data. I can change the data by opening up the source to adjust the different things in here, but there's no way to change the way that these data points. So I would definitely advise creating your charts and graphs in another program and copying and pasting them over Google Slides. That concludes a brief introduction on how to make Google Slides accessible for a screen reader. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. Check out the link in the description to find out how I can help you get accessible. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.